this is Pat Bamber here for PSB Sports with the Amir Khan official matchroom announcement signing press conference here at the Dorchester. I'm joined by head of Sky Boxing, Adam Smith. Adam, Happy New Year, how are you?
Happy New Year, how are you? I'm very well, thanks. You good?
I'm doing very well, thank you. I'm doing very well, even better for this very surprise announcement today. Obviously, no one really expected this, so how did this actually come about with Amir signing with Sky matchroom?
First of all, you know, it's a brilliant start for the new year. I'm really, really excited about having Amir Khan back. How did it come about? You never say never in boxing. I've been chipping away at Eddie for a long time to say that I think Amir should be back on Sky. I know I've known Amir a long time and we've kept in touch even if we've gone slightly different routes, but I think he's always wanted to be with us, and I think that the platform that he sees with Sky Sports News and the digital and social and the team that we've got is it's a team that can help him a lot. You know, it's a solid base, and with Matchroom's power too, I think that it's the right move for Amir, who wanted to come back to Britain. You know, look, he had a great time out in the jungle on ITV. I thought maybe he'd go to ITV, maybe he'd go with Frank at BT, and I'm really pleased. It's a major coup. It's a really good signing. I think, love him, hate him, think he's a huge talent with blistering speed, or think he's really vulnerable in the ring, you want to watch Amir Khan. He is box office. He's got a wonderful personality. He's an engaging guy to be around. I've always had a big soft spot for him, and I'm very pleased he's back. And I think we can help each other, and I think he's part of a huge year on Sky in 2018. And delighted. But it was tough.
Of course, I can imagine. But how important do you think it is now for Amir, now that he's back with Sky Sports, and I'll be fighting at home in the UK? He's obviously, a lot of the nation have got to know him now through RMSM to get me out of here in the jungle. And obviously, you know, before he went to the US, he was here fighting.
You had to watch every minute, didn't you?
Yeah.
I mean, it was a bit like when he fights, you can't take your eyes off him. I couldn't take, neither could my kids take their eyes off him in the jungle, whether it was the snakes or the strawberries or, you know, getting the geography wrong or whatever it was. He was great. He was Amir. He was the Amir that, you know, we all know and are lucky enough to have spent time with. I thought he was a lot of fun in the jungle. But that's done. That's, you know, a bit of reality television. He gets his name in the spotlight. But, you know, where he does his best work is in the ring. And I think he looks in great shape. I think he's out to prove people wrong. I think a lot of people have written him off before. And I think, look, he comes back at a time where Kell Brook wants to prove himself again. You know, he's had a bit of a setback, Kell. No one expected him to do probably as well as he did against Gennady Golovkin. But the Errol Spence defeat was tough for Kell. At the weight that he conquered, I think he made a mistake going back to welterweight. I'm really delighted he's gone up to 154. Errol Spence is a great fighter. And look, it's a great mix of that sort of weight with the Pacquiao's and the Spences and the Adrian Broners and everything that lies ahead, both at welter and up at 11 stone. I think there's huge fights to be made. But obviously, one of the big enticing things about the Matchroom deal is that when they're both under the same umbrella, it makes that fight easier. And I think we all want to see Brook and Khan. We've waited too long for it. Let's get it on. Let's have one, maybe two, maybe three fights. Look, it took us 5 years to make Mayweather-Pacquiao. We never got Hatton-Witter. We want Brook and Khan, or Khan and Brook. No one knows who's going to win. That's what boxing needs. That's what the fans want to see. And I think at some point, because of the new deal, because of the new allegiance, we will see that happen.
I'm going to ask you about, obviously, yesterday there was on Sky Sports News, it was announced obviously David Higgins and Eddie Hearn have had a meeting in regards to Joshua versus Parker. Adam, do you know potentially if this fight is close to happening at all?
Fingers crossed. I'm sure it's closer day by day. At least I hope it is. I had a good meeting with Freddie Cunningham last week, Anthony's business manager, and he was hopeful. I talked to AJ 2-3 months ago, and he said, "Look, who do you think I should fight next?" I said, "Joseph Parker." I said, "I think it's the right fight at the right time. It's a fight you're not necessarily going to win, but you should win. It's a battle of the unbeaten's. Joseph Parker has always fancied a crack at Anthony Joshua. His promotional outfit are great fun with the chin and all the stuff that they're getting ready for. And look, it's a fight because it's a unification. Parker's got the WBO title, and apart from Deontay Wilder with the WBC belt, Joshua has the rest. So I think it's a great match to be made. Hopefully at the end of March, here in in Britain. But yeah, there's still work to do. You know, Eddie and Frank Smith will be working extremely hard with Team Parker to get it over the line. I fully expect sense to prevail and the fight to happen. I think it works for Joseph Parker. I think it works for Anthony Joshua. And we need a big fight for AJ now. You know, we had the whole Pulev Takam thing at the end of last year, which I think was okay after what happened with Klitschko. Carlos Takam put a great shift in, didn't he? He gave everything he could at 10, 11 days' notice. And I think we need a unification fight to really get the juices flowing to kick off 2018 for a year in which I think Anthony Joshua will fight three times. And I think it will be another massive year for him and for us.
And obviously, I know Tyson Fury today is going to be reapplying for his license. Also, throw Tyson Fury in the mix.
He's been non-stop on the phone to everybody, I believe, Tyson Fury. He wants to be part of it again. And we want Tyson Fury back. Yes, he's got to go through that sort of big final hurdle of the British board. They have to make sure mentally, physically, he's fit. He's got to still lose weight. But look, I like the noise coming out of Tyson Fury. He's got that passion again. He's got that bit between the teeth. And it's something he lost after that wonderful win out in Germany against Vladimir Klitschko. He didn't really build on that. Now's his chance to be back in. He believes he's the king. Anthony Joshua believes he is. And of course, let's not forget our friend over in America, Deontay Wilder, who we worked with on the Joshua Klitschko fight, who will be looking hopefully to get back to work with us on Joshua Parker. We want to continue to see what Deontay Wilder does in 2018. These are difficult fights to make. Fury's not quite ready. We've got to see him back. You know, when is Fury Joshua going to happen? When is Fury against Wilder going to happen? When's Joshua Wilder? These three fights are massive, and I think they will happen, but I think it will take time. In the meantime, I want to see the Parker fight. I want to see AJ hit America, and I want to see what happens when Hay and Bellew get back in the ring, because if Tony Bellew beats David Hay again, he can fight Fury. If David Hay beats Tony Bellew, we could have a trilogy, or Hay could be back in the AJ sweepstakes. So, you know, there's a lot that's going to happen in the next 4 or 5 months. What I know is good news is that fight fans are going to see the heavyweights back and the heavyweights thriving.
Absolutely. Well, I'm sure the fans have had a great update from yourself in terms of what they can expect this year in 2018, and I'm sure everyone looks forward to it.
No problem. We hope so. It's good to be back, isn't it? It was nice to have a quieter Christmas. There's a lot of stuff coming up on BT, on ITV. There's great cross competition, which we embrace. I think every single one of my team wants to be ringside for Eubank and Groves, you know, despite the fact that it's not with us. So we're looking at everything across the year. We hope that the fight fans can get everything they need. But we're pretty confident on Sky that we've got some big names, big fights, and big nights ahead. And we hope that everybody gets good value out of it. We're certainly looking forward to doing our best to ramping up content both on digital and social, and trying to bring the best fights we can possibly bring.
Hello, Sky Boxing Anderson. Thank you very much for the time today. We wish you all the best.
No problem. Happy New Year.
Thank you. Happy New Year.